right, ladies and gentlemen, Baron here. We are going to be taking out the SU-57. Make one quick note. Battle rating 2.3, 57mm gun, M1 cannon. This one, the ZIS-30, battle rating 2.7, 57mm ZIS-2 gun. Not all 57mm guns are created equal. The Soviet gun is, in fact, superior. Oh, hello there, friend. He didn't really know. I just spawned in, and he was going full throttle. Actually, let's see if we can't get over to Charlie Day. See if that's going to work out. What's the matchmaking like? I think I should take the ZIS-30 out of my lineup, and I would get more favorable matchmaking, but I did not. So we're going to rearm real quick. But yeah, so this is an M3 gun motor carriage, GMC, half track, with a 57mm gun on it. When I first played this, I thought it was a Soviet 57. I didn't know Americans produced 57mm guns, interestingly enough. But they did. And they lend and lease them under the Lend-Lease program to Soviet Russia. And kind of a cool bit of history was, obviously, one of the perceived safer routes to get material. Well, actually, yeah, one of the only ways to get material to the Soviet Union via the Atlantic, so from Great Britain and the United States East Coast, was to go to these northern ports, Murmansk and Arkhangelsk, I believe. Oh, actually, let's see if we can't pop somebody. That's a friendly. But yeah, this might be a decent spot actually. Might finally. Oh, there we go. There's a hit though. Did it do anything? No. It's BT-7. Oh, that'll do. But yeah, some kind of cool stuff. I'm a big fan of like grand strategy games, specifically the board game Axis and Allies. And I remember my friend Pete and I tried to like create Super Axis and Allies, and I wanted to incorporate ports, but that's neither here nor there. So I did a lot of research about kind of like grand strategy World War II. But Lend-Lease program is kind of cool for us because it could indicate, I mean, this is a Lend-Lease vehicle. The Russians now have access to it. This could be problematic because you can see my gun depression is poop. And everyone's going to be able to see me once I pop up. So it's all about, can I hit him? No, I cannot. That's just downright terrible right here. Let's see. Aw, tits. Of course I run into, what is this? Oh my gosh. Yeah, this is why you look both ways before crossing the road. But anyway, as we sit here about to die. Oh my gosh. The Gepard. Of all things he could have ran into, he's like, oh, yes, it's a half-track. And then he just spammed us. He just shot my guy's knee off. Can you imagine getting hit right there in the knee with a 20mm? You would, you definitely lose your leg there. But, Lend-Lease, right? So the Russians got American tanks as well as British tanks and other armored vehicles for both nations. And I think that'd be kind of cool to see those implemented in the game, because you know it'd be great use of premium vehicles is to have other nations. Da, da, da. Damn, we gotta relocate. Still looking for a decent firing spot, because if you're out in the open, honestly, like 50 cal machine guns can tear you up. Anything's gonna be able to penetrate you. Give me a kill. What? We bounced. We are at what? There we go. There's some penetration. Enemy kill assist. No way. We were robbed of one of our few opportunities. But yeah, so I think if you're going to pick between, there's obviously a battle rating issue. So the battle I'm in. Oh, that's an M10. Let's take it out. Oh, he just peeled back. If he peeks out though, we're gonna take him. Huh. But yeah, I think it'd be great to have British tanks in the service of the Soviet Union. They'd be great premium tanks. I think everyone would buy them. And I think that the Germans should have French tanks. As well as Italian tanks would be good premiums right now. The Germans did operate some Italian tanks, and they operated a decent amount of French tanks when they captured them all. Finally, a kill. There we go. Now, we got to watch out for this M16. That thing's incredibly dangerous to us. Anything fast firing. Keep your head down, Mr. M16. We're going to follow another Soviet tank destroyer. I consider this more of a tank destroyer. Oh, titty fish. He's just laying covering fire down. So me and this SU-76, holy crap, they have all the cap points. We're just going to lose this. Because they just got that little, like, bonus thing. Look at that. What a bunch of poop. What a bunch of poopy. Let's see. Oh, here we go. A Panzer III J. Will he pop up again? Please? Am I charging the objective? Yeah, I don't know if it'll matter, though. Yeah, because we already have some guy capturing A. Oh, man, that would have been fun. Ooh, Zis 30. Let's kill him. Did someone hit me? Wow, really? A miss? Ground unit destroyed. Hit the ammunition rack. So that is that. We're going to take the Zis 30 out of it real quick. We're going to look at, you know, the difference in penetration and stuff like that real quick. We actually got third on our team, but we were the losing team. All right, so I don't know what happened. I think I almost had a game crash, but regardless, we are proceeding. So let's look at the M1. You've got M70 and M86 shells. You can see here that the highest penetration for the M86s is 98 millimeters of penetration at 500 meters. M70, on the other hand, has 112 millimeters of penetration at 500 meters. Now, if you check out the Zis 30, it's all a matter of like which platform do you want. Really, I think. Or this one's gun is considerably better. And it has high explosive rounds. But if you're firing high explosive with a 57mm gun, you're doing it wrong. So, armor-piercing high explosive ballistic cap shells. Pretty good penetration right there. I would say they're better than the second ones. And these ones have pretty good penetration. A little bit better. What? 135, 134, and 111. Let's take one quick look at the SU-57. Yeah, actually this one's a little bit better. Interesting. It's got 1 millimeter of penetration at 10, 100, and 500 meters. So that's pretty funny right there. But there is a battle rating difference. What? I swear when I was in arcade, it said 2.7. Something said 2.7. I must be losing my mind. But we're going to take this bad boy out again and see how we fare a second time around. But look at the armor, right? Zis 30, 10 millimeters, pretty much at your strongest, except your gun barrel, which is 23 millimeters, 7 millimeters on the side. You've got a crew of 4, so you can survive a little bit longer, even though you can, you know, take a couple hits. The crew members can die out. You know, basically, once you drop to one crew member, it's done. SU-57, also 4 crew members, and as far as armor goes, you're a little bit better right here at 12.7, but other areas, you're weaker at 6.35. So it's got slightly better armor. Yep, the Zis 30, that is. So it's all a matter of kind of which one is your favorite, you know? If they're both the same tier, and they have pretty similar guns, 57mm guns, which one do you like better? Look how long this one is relative to this one. Much shorter. But those American rounds, I guess, have equal penetration. I don't know if that's historical or just for the gameplay. Who knows? Let's check out some more action. All right, so we're back on Hurtgenforst in the SU-57. Look at that! See? I know I wasn't losing my mind. The battle rating changed. What is with that? That's so weird. We also have this bad boy in here, which is 2.7. I swear, man. I also thought this was 2.3. I thought I matched everything up. I'm not losing my mind. Ooh, look at that. Wait a minute. Oh. Okay, it said M8A1. You know what? I think I'm losing my mind, guys. Because I could have sworn it said M3. 75mm M3 gun motor carriage in front of the M8A1. Did anyone else see that? Are there ghosts, man? Am I losing my mind? I don't really know. There could be, like, these ghosts, man. Ghosts and stuff, like, affecting... I don't know, guys. I'm really weirded out. But anyway, so, premium tanks, right? I'm a big proponent of introducing tanks from other nations that aren't in the game, those tech trees in the game that are reasonable. The Germans overran France. They had Charby-1s, Charby-2s, Somoa S-35s, Renault R-35s. I believe it was Renault R-35s. There was like a bunch of French tanks that were used by the Germans. Those would be great. They're also going to be some of the best like Tier 1 and Tier 2 tanks in the game, I'm pretty sure. Hello, peekaboo. All right, we got to move up a bit. Not see anybody. Oh. Oh, shit. All right, I guess we can... Oh, shit. Go, 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 go. He started firing his machine guns, which was pretty smart, and damaged us. Look at that. There's... I swear, man, there's ghosts. We're going to repair right here in the middle. Okay, so, yeah. The Germans should have a bunch of French tanks as premium. The Russians were also lended British tanks. Valentine's, I think maybe even Matilda's. Can you imagine how many people would buy the Matilda if it was a Russian premium? I'll tell you this, man. I think it'd be the hottest selling premium vehicle in War Thunder to date if you were to introduce a Russian Soviet, or excuse me, a Russian premium Matilda. Oh, look at the crew members. Hey, boys. They just kind of like popped up. Okay, here's the gun motor carriage. Maybe, I don't know, man, the ghosts. How are we doing? Do we have an assist? No, we did not get an assist on that hit. Oh, Zis 30 just got wrecked. Oh, we do not like artillery. We're very, very weak. What, 6mm armor, you guys? You know, what do you expect? Are we pushing up? Yeah, we should be flanking. Look at that M4A1. I wish I was driving that thing right now. Run! Oh, we made it. Look, M10s. That's because of that, like, Phantom, the Phantom Menace. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. I don't know if we're gonna make it. I don't even care about those tanks, man. I just gotta run from the bombs. We did make it! Hell yeah! Oh, hell yeah! And now we're actually gonna be doing what we should be doing, is flanking. Running from the crazy ghosts. Alright, what is that? A Panzer IV F2. That's a tank. I could... Oh, T-28s. Did we hit it? We did not hit it. It's a bunch of titty fish. We need to just get some points, man, with this thing. How's that not killing everybody? What? Oh, that's why. Relocate! Oh, man, we just got blown up. I wonder if he used high explosive rounds. But yeah, so a Russian Matilda. Think about that. Did that just go through the wall? Are there more? I swear, guys. Some crazy stuff. Phantom battle ratings, shooting through walls. We're holding it down, so now I'm gonna use these rounds because they've got better penetration, and when I get closer, I'll use the second rounds, which have, you know, better explosive properties once penetrating an enemy tank. So we're gonna keep it like that. Oh, we're losing it. But yeah, and then I think the Charby 1 would also be a huge... It'd be a Tier 1 KV-1, basically. It's just so awesome. Intelligence. Why not? Take a pot shot, see what happens. Alright, so Panzer IV F2 with the beautiful, amazing 75mm gun. Now that A6M3 could probably tear us up. Alright, this should be good. Nope. We gotta push up a little more. There we go. Look at that, right in the gun barrel, dude. How did... We gotta do like slight adjustments, but we can't really see anything. There are a ton of tanks. Look at this. I think that's a Sherman. Just charging. There we go. There's green. So what would you think? What do you think, what would you buy? Would you buy a French premium tank serving under the Germans? Would you buy a Matilda tank, a Valentine tank, that the Russians have? I can most assuredly tell you that I would. Can we hit him? That'd be really cool. Here we go. Is that a Gepard? Kind of looks like it. Nope. He's bailing. He's running. So here we go, some sniping situations, not too bad. Still kind of tricky to hit him. Oh, and he's moving. We're just shelling, we're running out of shells. Because we're just firing everything, sniping. And he's moving just a little bit. Just enough to keep it honest. Alright, so it looks like there's someone up close. We'll switch over. Play peekaboo here. There's no one really pushing up and scouting on this side. Everyone's just staying. Oh, that Stug's in the middle. Shots are being fired. If I could see where they're coming from, I could take shots. That'd be cool if that went through the house. Flak truck! Come on, we want to hit this flak truck on the run. Knock. Aw, come on, Mr. Flak. Flackety flack, don't talk back. I'm getting really distracted because this is not a tank you can really just run in there and gun with. Or even like, you know, when you can't take shots, I'm just like, oh my tits, mates. Critical hit. Beautiful. There's a kill. Alright, we killed a Sherman. Was that a Sherman? I don't know, but two kills, man. That's good for me. This, I would say it's kind of a challenge vehicle. Especially, what? Fighting at 2.7. Tits, mate. That is not what we wanted to be doing. But you saw it. You saw how the battle ratings changed, and that was just absolutely crazy. The ghosts, man. There's War Thunder ghosts. Should we use a bomber? Yeah, we should. Oh. I should have pressed 9 and then retreated because you have 15 seconds. Noob move. But now we're just rolling up, trying to brawl. Should we be doing that? No! Who's that? It's the damn flak truck. There we go. But it didn't slow him down. Can't really tell where this guy's going. We can't critical him. There's a critical. We need him to stop. So we can kill him. Oh shit. The driver's unconscious. That's why. M2A4. Look at what happens. Incoming artillery fire. We're basically gonna get wrecked here. Oh! M2A4, you won't come up here and say hi. Oh, artillery. Run! Did the rammer kill him? Oh no. Oh, what the tits! Oh man, I think that's some of the craziest stuff that's happened, and there you go. High explosive artillery will wreck ya. Similar to the Hellcat, similar to Jackson, similar to the Wolverine. These new lightly armored stuff, it's kind of funny to see. Maybe there'll be a plane, right, in the last couple seconds. And victories are, so... ridiculous stuff, man. I'm still just trying to figure it out. What exactly happened? Did we get... we got no assists either. Yep. I'm a noob at this thing. No assists. Poop. But it's fun. And I do like it. I wish they were adding armored cars. The last time I said armored cars, I mentioned the Puma. And people were like, what's the Puma? If you Google it, Puma armored car. It was a German armored car with a 50mm gun on it, which was pretty, pretty awesome. So, it'd be fun to have more stuff like that running around. Just to make things a little more interesting. Also, like I said, man, the Russian premium British tanks, or the British tanks that are Russian premiums, and the French, and maybe even some Italian tanks that are German premiums, that'd be pretty cool. I'd love to see that. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Baron. Thank you all for watching. Make sure to pull the trigger on the like button. Let me know which tank you want me to drive out next, and I'll see you guys soon.